What's going on, guys? David here again, back with another video for your home man cave, home arcade, home theater, whatever, all your home electronic stuff. Today I got an interesting product I want to talk about. It's a mesh Wi-Fi system product, and I want to talk to you about it in more simple layman's terms. I've watched a lot of these reviews on YouTube and stuff, and some of them kind of gave me the answers I wanted, but there was a lot of technical talk and stuff that is over my head or whatever. So I want to try to break it down a little bit easier to make it understand for you why you might need it for your home arcade, your man cave, your home theater, or whatever. If you're like me, my man cave is on the other side of the house from my Wi-Fi network, so I had to find a way to get it up here, and I've looked into the mesh network, and it's always just been a little intimidating to me. So when I started looking at it, I was looking at some of the cheaper mesh products, all the way to like the Aero by Amazon. And I've got a lot of Amazon, you know, the Alexa products and stuff like that. So I kind of want to stay with Amazon. Everything in the future seems Amazon's going to. So, but anyway, their most expensive piece was $200 for one router. And of course, so I'm going to talk about price point real quick. It was $200 for one, which hooked up to your main modem, your main router. So it was still going to be on the other side of the house. So I'd have to buy at least a second one to reach up here, which would have been $400, and I kind of figured I might even need three, depending on how far they needed to reach, which would have been $600 for three of them, which is, you know, a hit to the bank account. So the good thing about that was it reached 66 up to, I think, up to 60 feet, where the one I got is 30. But anyway, we'll break that down. But I wanted to shy away from that one. The one I ended up picking up was the Mesh Force. And this one I do highly recommend on Amazon. For three of these, it was $169.99, and I was able to luckily get, I looked on there and there's a $30 coupon for it, so I got it for what, $139.99 for all three of them. I went with this one. My buddy actually showed it to me. He got the black version, so they come in white and black. He got the black version for his house. He has a PS4 Pro up in his room, smart TV. His son's got an Xbox Series S, and they need a power upstairs to run all these better. It was fine for him with his normal stuff for his TV and his movies, but when you start getting into PS4, PS5, your Xbox Series X and all that kind of stuff, you need more power, especially if your computers and all that stuff too. So anyway, he used this one, used the black version, said it was phenomenal, it was awesome, and hey, it was less than $200 for all three of them, which is less than the cost of one of the Aeros by Amazon. So, of course, I asked him how well it worked and all that stuff, and he said it was awesome. So, moving into what does this do? So, basically, of course, you have a Wi-Fi router, and it puts out a signal, obviously, in your house. So, you can get a Wi-Fi extender, which is what I originally had, but all it does is extend the connection, and it's at best maybe 50% of the download and upload speeds that your router would be. So what a mesh network does is it basically duplicates that signal to keep it consistent. So pretty much 100% of what is down in my router on the other end of our house is in my mesh network up here. I basically have 100% of the same power instead of 50% of the other power. And now up here for me and most of you with your home arcades, theaters, and so on, especially man caves, bar caves, whatever, you run multiple TVs because you watch multiple sports games, or, I mean, just simply a movie. The last thing you want is to sit there and be watching a movie by yourself or with the family, and it buffers every 20 seconds. And now for me personally up here, even running one TV, sometimes it would buffer through a football game. There's nothing more irritating than that to me. And up here, I'm into fantasy football, so I have three TVs so I can watch them simultaneously. But even during the rest of the year, I can watch hockey, NASCAR, movies and whatnot. And the extender did okay. The extender, I think I paid 50 or 60 bucks for, is by Netgear, and it did fine for the most part. But I wanted something 100% more reliable. I also have, for the home arcade guys, I have NBA Jam, which we all know is live, which means it's Wi-Fi enabled. They also have Marvel vs. Capcom, and that looks like they're coming out with a new Street Fighter that's going to be live. So you have more arcade cabinets too that are going to be on Wi-Fi and sucking power. So up here on a normal, you know, not a normal night, but on a weekend, if I have friends over and stuff and we're watching football games or sports on TVs, We're playing the arcade games. Maybe somebody fires up the Xbox and wants to play a game on it on one of the other TVs or something. That's sucking a lot of power. And on that little Wi-Fi extender, it's going to start messing everything up. So this mesh network has been a blessing in disguise. Everybody can use it, especially most man caves and home arcade stuff are usually in a basement or upstairs in a bonus room. And sometimes away from that router. And even if you have one router in the center of the house, these will just help power, because I think each one can do like 75 devices. Oh, my Philips Hue. Let's talk, you know, Govee lights, all that stuff too. I would have to stand in the doorway sometimes to be able to work my Philips Hue lights to get the Wi-Fi signal. And that's irritating if I'm sitting down. I just want to turn them a different color, turn them on, and I can't. I have to do that. So anyway, set up on this Mesh Force was a breeze. Now, they scare a lot of people and stuff, but it's so easy. You pull out your first one, you plug it in, you set it down, you run your Ethernet cable to your modem, download the app, and it's going to tell you right what to do. It's going to automatically start doing things. You basically name your network, you connect it to the Wi-Fi, you set up a password, and it pretty much does all the work for you. I mean, it is super simple to do. I'll leave a link down below. It's not affiliated or anything, but I'll leave a link below so that you can go look at this one. But anyway, so you follow those simple steps. And then the other one's easy too. So these are 30 feet distance. So you want to keep everything within 30 feet. Took the second one that I had. I put it in our dining room, which is basically a little bit below and angled away from me that way. Put the second one in there, powered it, plug the power into it, and basically it sets up. It sets there and does a thing. I think you had to click it to the network, and then you put in the password that you already had, and it finds it, and if it lights up green, perfectly connected. If it blinks yellow, it's partially connected. If it's red, it's not connected. So it's very simple to look at it and see that it's set up. Once it lights up green, you know you're perfect. And you go do the same thing with your third one. And like I said, it's up here. It's right behind y'all, right next to my Xbox. It sits right there. It lights up green. Same thing. You go to it, password, all that good stuff. Super simple. And it's set up and done. The last thing I'll say that I really wanted, I don't know if it's the last thing, but one of the things I wanted too was the ability to still have a wired connection from these other mesh points upstairs here. I didn't want... mainly my Xbox. I got a Series X. I did not want it to run off Wi-Fi. I wanted it to be plugged in because those things suck a lot of power and a lot of internet. So all of these, including the one downstairs, so I plugged the Ethernet into the first one. That's the primary one. There's actually another port. So I plugged that port into my Xbox Series S downstairs. Up here, excuse me, I have two free ones. I plugged one into the Xbox. And if I bring the Series S up here to play with my daughter, play with somebody else, play some video games, I have another one I can plug it in to. It's got two open slots on the back, so I can run it to both them. But even so, I mean, the Wi-Fi will be plenty of power for the Series S up here and running all the other things. So that was something I wanted, was to make sure that I could wire my Series X in. That was the whole reason, basically, that I bought this. Not the whole reason, because you don't want to watch movies and stuff and it buffer and mess up. So, and the extender definitely did that, where this has not yet messed up on me at all. I've had it about a week now, and I've played video games on the Series X. It's 4K, all that good stuff. Haven't had a problem. I've turned everything on up here to see how it did with it. It worked just fine. I think I'm, you know, right there at the end of the connections, so maybe over time I might have to find little spots to tweak it to make sure they're close enough together. I don't know yet. I haven't had a problem, so let me make that clear. Have not had a problem with it. It's worked great, less than $200. Now my man cave, everything runs flawlessly, great on it. My Philips Hue, I can always stay on Wi-Fi on my phone, no problem working it. So like I said, I'm gonna drop a link below, but look for this if you need stronger Wi-Fi connection somewhere in your house. Maybe you have a three floor house, two floor house, whatever, or bricks or something that just kind of mess up your signal, garage. Definitely look into something like this. It's super simple, easy to do. I hate that I waited so long to do it, but I was intimidated by technology and how hard it is, but everything's being made so much easier to do these days. Definitely check this system out. $169.99 on Amazon. Maybe you could wait out and find a coupon for it. I got lucky and found mine. I'd still pay the $170 for it. no problem to have this ease of use up here that I have. So definitely check into it. Definitely great for your house, smart home, office, whatever you need, wherever you need extra Wi-Fi. And I believe they also come in one and two packs as well. So if you, maybe your house isn't as big, but you need more, you know, that works too. Full house 6,000. So this one covers six. So these three cover 6,000 feet. Two mesh points, 2,000 to 4,000. One mesh point is 1,500 to 2,000 square feet. So our house is about 3,000 square feet, but I want to make sure. So I got three of them. You know, going through walls and stuff, you do kind of lose signal. And there's a lot. There's a couple walls and stairs and stuff between me and the other ones. So I just want to make sure I had that extra juice. And at 170, it definitely was. It was a bargain for me. So definitely check them out. Check those out. Get them for your office, your home theater, your home arcade, whatever you need. But hey, guys, that's it for this one. On the next one. Out.